long-term program can be developed?
Yeah, this is a very valid question again. I don't know whether you listened to our national coach Pulela Gopichand speak about this particular topic a couple of days back. So what he said was, he had a child. He said his whole approach to coaching changed a couple of years back when a small child who looked very clumsy to him, extremely clumsy, and he was even cursing her in his mind, not openly, that why the hell did this such a kind of child come to my camp? Beginner level camp, of course, who couldn't even connect the shuttle, who couldn't even throw a shuttle, who couldn't even catch a shuttle. So as they were filing out of the court, it seemed the small girl approached him and said, "Sir, teach me how to throw." That, I think, brought tears to his eyes.
Yeah.
And he says that particular incident changed his whole mindset. So he's, I think, after creating a phenomenal performance as a national coach with 6 to 7 world-class players out of nowhere, almost like a magician. Of course, great work behind that, as you would know.
Yeah.
But there, I think, I see a paradigm shift from extremely focused elite-level coaching to more wider canvas of spreading sports literacy among the whole country. I mean, a very big platform ahead of him, I feel. But coming to the specific question which you said, he kept mentioning also that there is a thing called physical literacy. Just as you have alphabet literacy, which means again words and sentences and reading and language, just as you have numerical literacy, where you deal with numbers, addition, multiplication, advanced math, there is also physical literacy. The simple exercises of running, jumping, climbing, throwing, catching and kicking. So if a child systematically is taught all this from a very young age, this problem would not have happened.
How young, sir?
Yeah. So this, the advanced nations, especially the West, have gone through this in detail over the last couple of decades. Each country, especially Canada, UK, US and all, have come out with a program called long-term athlete development. You could, our friends, whoever is listening to us on this program, do please have a look at LTAD of Sports Canada.
Yeah.
So it's very clear in the sense it clearly says the age of the child and what they should be doing. This is Canada. I think it was small with minor alterations. This must be followed in other countries. So they say active, call this first stage active start. That is age 0 to 6, where the basic activities like running, throwing, catching, kicking and twisting are taught. Nothing else. And the child may go to multiple sporting venues. May not be playing, but to multiple venues. So that is 0 to 6. And then so comes fundamentals.
So this is also fundamentals of motor skills and cognitive development. So
Correct. Then they slowly move on from 6 to 9 years. They vary it for boys and girls with a small variation, but that I am leaving it for the time being. That they call fundamentals. F-U-N in capital letters, fundamentals. Yeah. So there begins the ABCs of coaching, whatever sport the child is going to. Multiple sport, like I said, there is no specialization at all at that period. Even the next level, which they call learning to train, which is 9 to 12 years, also there is no specialization.
Okay.
Next level where they train to train, that is 12 to 16, I think they will bring down the number of games from 3 to 2, but they still are playing 2 games, 2 sports.
Wow.
I was listening to Federer and Nadal, both of them were playing tennis and football side by side till 12 years.
Wow.
Of course, Nadal was a far better football player. So Federer also was a good enough football player and he could play badminton also.
Wow.
And at 12, they specialized. So that's how it goes in advanced countries. And that's supposed to go in advanced countries.
Wow. So that's the proof. All my viewers here, please note that point. It's a fundamental at 6 to 9 and then they specialize specialization for 2 sports. As Balan sir, the master has said here, and including Roger Federer and Nadal, they have been playing 2 sports
from
the age of 12 to 16. That's fantastic, sir. Please continue.
Yeah, and then they come to learning to compete between 16 and 18. Of course, I mean, they must have been playing tournaments before, no doubt about that. But the focus on competition starts only between 16 to 18. Okay? And then it is training to compete between 18 to 21, where exactly where a clear annual or even micro plans are made for their tournament participation. Focus by the coaches on tactical acumen, how to tackle the psychological factors during competition, all those things.
Yes.
Seventh level is learning to win. That is pretty much an advanced level if the child reaches that stage.
Okay.
Then again is winning for a living. All those things which go into the making of a champion player, how professional he has to be, how to juggle with endorsement deals, contracts, all those kind of things. And finally, stage 9 is active for life. After the sport, what?
Yeah.
How will you survive? How are you going to? Are you going to get employment or are you going to take up coaching? Advice and counsel about those. So this is pretty much the calendar of events they have prepared for a sports person. Great work. I hope our country also migrates to that kind of a platform.